What is up, guys? We are back with another video, and this is sort of a vlog style video. So if you've noticed lately, the background of this video or the videos that you've seen lately have changed just a little bit. You might be able to tell that I'm in a new space now. And basically, my girlfriend and I, we had moved. So we were living in a three-story townhouse, which was awesome because I had my own office. And the whole plan was that she had got a job across the country where she had to go to training for 6 months, somewhere completely different. So the whole idea was that we were going to go ahead and I was gonna get just a small apartment for those 6 months. And then she's gonna go to training. And then of course we were gonna move all the way across the country. That didn't happen because of COVID. She's still here, but because our lease was up at our old place and it was all these things, we just decided to move into a one bedroom apartment together, which is a little crazy having all that space and then condensing everything down. But we set up my office in the living room because obviously that was the only place for it. So I wanted to give you guys a little behind the scenes of, you know, this office, how I shoot videos, and kind of how we have everything set up. So let's go ahead and take a look. So here is sort of like an overview of what the whole setup looks like. Compared to my old office, I actually have more space lengthwise, which is actually kind of nice. It allows me to have some more room for actually shooting videos. And talking about shooting videos, this is kind of what the setup looks like. I have my camera, obviously, and then I sit in the chair and we have our two lights. I'm still using my Sony a6300. It's just been the proven camera that I use. It's really great for what I use it for. And then the lights, if you guys are wondering, these are newer lights that I bought off Amazon. They were really cheap and I actually really like them. You can adjust the brightness here pretty easily. You know, with the dial here, and then you can turn off different sections of the LED light. And I know so many people are like, yeah, get the ones that don't have power connectors, get the ones that have batteries, but those batteries run out so fast. I've learned that in the past. So you just buy these big ass extension cables that go all the way over here. It just makes it easier. So when you're shooting, you don't run out of battery and then you have to recharge and you have to stop and all that kind of stuff. So here is my main setup. This is where I work. This is where you obviously see me shoot videos. We did a vlog on this setup before, Autonomous Smart Desk 2. We're obviously not gonna go on to everything in detail, but this is my setup. And I definitely like to keep my setup clean. That's my big thing. Not a whole lot of stuff on the desk, as you guys can see here. That is my main PC, which we also did a video on. So if you guys wanna check that out, we'll have links below to that. That was such a fun build. Pretty much all Corsair build there, as you guys can see. So yeah, that is the main setup there. And then here is all of my camera stuff. So anything that has to do with cameras, like this top section, minus the to-do list, which I'll move. But this top section usually has everything that I need to grab really quickly. So like my microphones are in here, obviously I'm using them. And then my A6300 sits here, and then I have some other stuff right there. Tripods and different things. And as you can see, I like mini tripods because I have a ton. And then I have my camera bag. If I'm going somewhere, it is all right there. And then we move over here, which I'm trying to move over to what we see, what you guys, if you guys have been following the channel for a while, you guys know this. This is our storage shelves right here that has all of the boxes. We really don't use this all that much as far as a set. It's mainly storage. And pretty much everything that you see here is in the box. So I don't have a whole lot of extra storage in this place. So having the storage here, you know, we can grab a board if we need it or a graphics card. And then I have all little collectibles and things like that that I have kind of sitting up there. And then we move over to here, which was kind of like a new addition because I have more space lengthwise. I set up these two desks. They're from IKEA, extremely cheap. And it allows me to have like a dedicated test system, dedicated spot for products, product shots, testing, monitors, things like that. I have this dedicated space, which is nice. Over here, we have our 4K monitor for graphics card testing. One of our test benches right here, We just finished reviewing the Z490 Extreme 4 from ASRock, so we have that there. Corsair One, another motherboard, just a bunch of things that we're currently reviewing. Talking about test setups or test benches, we have another one down here, which is a Praxis wet bench, although we're running air cooling on that one. And then the third one is right up there, and that's what we do all of our air cooling, CPU cooler reviews on there. And then as you guys can see, we have this massive storage setup. Over here is like everything that we have into review, boxes upon boxes of things, and it continues over here. Just everything that I haven't taken pictures of yet kind of just sits here. Some cool things. We have ASRock B550 Tai Chi. Really excited to check that board out. We also have the ROG Rapture GT AX 1100, or 11,000, sorry. That is one awesome router. I'm really excited to do a video on that one as well. But we have, again, a ton of stuff there. I have my little charging setup here, which is mostly batteries for cameras. I do have wireless headphones there as well, and some batteries, other batteries that I charge. And then we have like all this storage. These bins have been extremely helpful just for the fact that like they're clear, I can see what's in them, I don't need to label them, and they're small. Like I do have some bigger ones down there, but like these small ones are perfect for what I use them for. Here's like business cards, and I haven't put these in there yet, but like think computer stickers. We have memory in this one, CPUs in that one, you know, LAN cables. They're just like the perfect size. So if you're looking for storage, those are pretty awesome, but mainly just all storage through here. And then another thing, we have this tabletop. So if I'm over here and I'm shooting something and I need a table, say it's like a case review or something like that, I put it on these legs, and then we have a table that I can easily take down and of course put over there. So that is the setup, guys. It's in the middle of my living room. It's not ideal, but it is kind of our temporary situation till we move. So yeah, guys, if you have any questions about this, go ahead and leave it in the comment section below. If you have suggestions on things we can do, like this wall is very white, but we can't paint it because we're renting, but maybe put something there. This desk obviously does go up and down because it's a sit stand desk, so that's something to think about. But in any case, guys, if you have suggestions, if you have questions, go ahead and leave it in the comment section below. Till next time, catch you guys later.